Just know that I'm gonna piss off a lot of Korean music fans, and I'm okay with that. I really don't care because I said what I said, I meant what I said, and I'll say it again. I do this for a living. YouTube is my full-time job. Ain't nothing anyone gonna say gonna faze me. I'm gonna say what I gotta say. Stay mad if you want to. Channel, and today's video is going to be a very difficult one for some audiences, so please do not proceed if you are sensitive to issues that pertain to people being hurt in a way that they should never be hurt. Please read between the lines, because in this video I'm going to be trying to choose my words very wisely, for the simple fact that I need this video to go out to as many people as possible, because not only is this message very, very important for the black girls who come across it, but it is very, very important for the people who support the people that I'm going to be talking about, know what their faves are doing out in these streets. But before we get into all of that, today's video is sponsored by BGL Jewelry. Now, we have worked with them before, and before you guys helped them sell out. BGL Jewelry is owned by a young black entrepreneur, and she is doing an amazing job, and I love the fact that you guys were part of her success, and we would love to do it again. She is now sponsoring this video. She sent me a brown skin girl's chain, very literally the same as before, but I kind of broke my last one because I'm very, very clumsy and I break my chains all the time. Like, this is my D-Mel chain and I've broken this at least 4 times. I'm very, very clumsy, but it's a very, very good quality chain. I absolutely love it and I wear it almost every day. I'm so happy she sent me another one. She also sent me this sparkly bracelet. Last time she sent me this Haitian inspired one and I love it. I never take it off. Really great quality. And she also sent me these hair clips. This one says iconic and this one says drippin'. Her stuff is super duper affordable and I know that is important for a lot of you guys during these times. However, if you're gonna buy anything, please make sure you support black business, because it is very, very important that we A, support our young entrepreneurs, and B, put money back into our black community. So make sure you guys head down to BGL Jewelry on Instagram or shopbgljewelry.com to get your pieces today. So we are going to be talking about One Nation. One Nation is a Korean rap group. There are 3 people in this group: Win, Jug, and Hobo. I just shortened their names, okay? So yeah, now these men range in age from like 22 years old to 29 years old. So basically they're being accused of using black girls for their personal pleasure. Now if you guys don't know what that means, please read between the lines. They are accused of forcing themselves on young girls. They are accused of taking young girls to hotel rooms. And most of these allegations are coming from group chats. Now, there are a lot of fangirls who have made group chats and have included One Nation in these fan chats, okay? So in these chats, they talk about all types of things. Sometimes they send memes, you know, their music, they share their appreciation and admiration for these group members. And instead of these group members just taking it all in and just saying, oh my God, thank you, we love you too, they'll sit there and be like, oh, but you wanna see my thing though? Like, what's good? Like, y'all trying to see my peen? Not joking, not over exaggerating. You can go see the receipts in the other videos as well as on Instagram. And this would be a constant thing, numerous group chats. Like, these, it's not just one group chat, 2 group chats. These are numerous group chats. To add insult to injury, they would also pressure these young girls to send nudes, okay? They would pressure these young girls to send inappropriate pictures of themselves. And when they did not, they were often ostracized and made fun of and demeaned because they didn't want to help pleasure the boys. They didn't want to make them happy. There are voice recordings of, I believe, Jug sitting there talking about how the group chats turn him on and he always gets hard from being in the group chats and he never leaves there without getting off. That's absolutely disgusting, and I genuinely do not understand how adults, especially adult men, can do something like this. Blew my mind. All these receipts blew my mind. You're probably like, okay, but they're from Korea. Like, how are they doing all of this? Well, they spend a lot of time in the US and in Korea. They bounce back and forth on a regular basis, so they spend a lot of time out here. If you guys do not know who One Nation is, listen, you're not alone. I ain't never heard of them either. I had to do some research And honestly, I'm very, very upset that I wasted my time. Now, Won Nation is a Korean rap group. And I'm gonna just say this right now. I enjoy certain K-pop songs. Certain Korean music is actually pretty good. However, this is Korean rap. I've heard some Korean rap music that also is pretty good. And if something is good, I'm going to give credit where it's due. It doesn't matter how I feel about the person or what the person has done. I can genuinely sit up here and say that someone's shit is good when it's good. But I'm gonna tell you this right now, I did my research on this group. I was listening to their music, I kid you not, I listened to at least 7 songs, and this music is horrible, it's garbage, it's straight up flat rap. And I have to say right now that I'm extremely disappointed in my black people, even thinking that this music was remotely good to give them any ounce of support, let alone let these Korean men, okay, but yet, these Korigas, yes, I said Korigas, let these Korigas try to think that they could disrespect us the way they done did. Music is horrible. It's not even SoundCloud quality, that's how bad it is. And just for reference, if you wanna know the songs that I'm specifically talking about that were like worse than all of them, they have 2 songs, one called Chinky Chan and the other one called Compliments. Those had to be the worst out of the 7 that I listened to. Search it up yourself. I ain't gonna leave no links to these trash ass motherfuckers because they are being dragged for something that I just, it's honestly unimaginable. I'm not surprised, but it's just unimaginable. Many of you who are fans or who are not fans may not be aware that this group is currently being accused, and I have to say accused because there have been no charges filed as of yet. There is nothing in the courts going on, so I have to say accused and alleged, and I will be saying that throughout the whole entire thing. But I will let you know right now, I will not be including any receipts in this video because I want to make sure this video goes out to as many people as possible, and I don't want anything jeopardizing those chances. So I'm going to link down 2 Instagram pages down below that have everything regarding the victims, the screenshots, and the receipts. There is One Nation Victims, and then there's One Nation is canceled, I believe, but nonetheless, the links are gonna be down below. Also, I'm going to link down other videos of people talking about this situation. Now, what's really sad about this situation is this situation has been going on for a while now. I would say, honestly, a couple of years, but it started surfacing on the internet as far as allegations until late 2019, and we are now in June 2020, and now this is becoming somewhat of a, I guess, viral-ish type of phenomenon, but not really, because not enough people know about this. And the reason this has taken so much time to get out is because these victims contacted numerous people who were friends with this group, trying to tell their stories, trying to get these people to hold their friends in One Nation accountable. And what happened? They were ignored. They were ostracized. They were made to feel like they were less than for speaking out against these men. Really, really sad about this situation is that there were numerous adults in these group chats as well that would sit there and egg on these situations. When a girl would not want to send a photo or comply with what the boys were asking for, they would make fun of these young girls. They would sit there and tell them that they're not being cooperative. These girls would even get kicked out of the chat. And you know, for the girls that did send their pictures, they were circulated around the internet. Yes, circulated around the internet. A lot of the people that these girls came to complain who were friends of these men were actually black. And the responses they got were absolutely appalling. They would sit there and be like, okay, well, you
had no business talking to these grown men, and oh, well, I'm not the police.
These are the responses that our black people were giving to our black children. You guys get upset when I say that black people, we are our biggest problem? Y'all get upset? Y'all get upset? This is absolutely disgusting, and I'm thoroughly annoyed and thoroughly upset at the lack of respect and integrity for our black children. For whatever reason, black girls are sexualized so badly. Black girls can't even be black girls. We are automatically born black women. I kid you not. It's disgusting. We can never have our childhood. We can never just be children. We can never just live our lives. Because there's always gonna be that man thinking that we're just sex objects, we're just sex toys, we just, you know, we're good for nothing. We're good for nothing but popping coochie, twerking, being ghetto loud, being ratchet, being angry, being sexual. A lot of girls experience this from the age of 14 and younger, and it's just not really fair. So I understand that a lot of people may be like, okay, but what can I do about it? Okay, well, I'm not the cops, but at the end of the day, when someone is contacting you, telling you something about your friends, telling you that your friends are doing something, You as a person needs to hold your friend accountable. And that's all they really ask for. For those people that ever sit there like, okay, well, why are you telling me this? Honestly, they're asking for you to hold the person accountable, if you know the person. Sometimes some people just be telling you shit and it's like, you know, maybe they just want you to listen. They just want advice. But at the same time, if you're friends with someone and someone is coming to tell you that that person you're friends with is doing some fuck shit, you need to be the friend. You need to be a person with morale, okay, and empathy to say something to that person, to hold that person accountable, because clearly that person feels like they do not have a voice. That person feels like they will not be heard. So it is up to you to do that for them. There's this one YouTuber in particular, okay, one influencer, her name is Lindsay Makeup, was parading the fact that she had news from one of these young girls in order to blackmail Jug. And honestly, this is just disgusting. Again, she's black as well. And I'm so disappointed. So eventually all of this hit the fan, and there's a YouTuber named Chili Got Soul who made like a whole 30 minute video talking about the situation, because she was actually friends with these people and she apologized for being friends with them and defending them in the past, because it wasn't just now that these things were going that these things were coming out. Like I said, these were coming out a long time ago, and she said herself that she has had people come up to her and tell her things about them, and she was constantly hearing things, but because she was friends with them, she didn't want to believe it. Now again, people might be upset about what I'm gonna say, she might see this and get upset about what I'm gonna say. But honestly, black people, people in general, we need to learn how to be better judges of character. We may not know what everyone does behind closed doors. We may not know what everyone is like. People flip on us and shit like that. But when people keep telling you something and they have a similar story, you have to pay attention to it. Especially if you are not gonna pay attention to it, you can't go around defending nobody. You just can't. I rarely defend anyone, like rarely, because I don't know what the fuck you do. I don't know what your intentions are and shit. You may be my friend, but I have been in situations in the past, like middle school, high school, and I learned it really, really young, that anytime someone is being accused of something, a chance that sometimes it may be true. There's a chance that there may be some truth to it. So I do not go around defending anyone because of shit like this. It's really, really strange to me how like she and a lot of other people were getting all of this information and no one did anything with it, and they sat there and defending them. It'd be one thing to just stay silent and be like, well, I don't believe this, but to defend them and you don't really even know the truth, to defend them and know that it may be an ounce of truth, it's just not acceptable. People constantly ask me to make videos about Korean music, K-pop in particular. I've done at least 3 videos on K-pop, and they've been music video reactions. I never really cared for it. It's not something that I really like care to listen to on a regular basis. Like I like the music. It's good music. It really is. It's good music, but it's just like I've always had a very eerie feeling and a very, very indifferent opinion about Korean music, because I feel like a lot of it, especially Korean rap and Korean hip hop, is a culture vulture type of genre. I feel like their music emulates black culture to a T, and the cultural appropriation is disgusting, okay? These Korigas, okay, I said Korigas, Korean wannabe niggas, be out here like just stealing our shit, okay? And I don't like it because they're not even doing it right. A lot of it sounds like garbage, okay? There's only a token few that sound decent, but a lot of it sounds like garbage. Disrespectful in a way. It doesn't sound like they even care about what they're producing. It doesn't sound like they even care about how they're being portrayed, because it just sounds like garbage. And again, if you're going to take someone's culture and do something with it, you need to at least do it well. You need to pay it homage. Like, I know there's a lot of black people who are obsessed with Korean culture, which honestly I find really, really interesting. Like, I'm not gonna be like, oh, it's wrong or anything like that, but it is a little weird because Koreans literally jack our culture all damn day. So I guess I just wish that black people will put this much energy into the community, as well as the black women and black men who make music, especially conscious music in our communities, that they do into Korigas that sound just like the black people in the community. I'm just saying, I said what I said. I'm not saying don't appreciate Korean culture or any other culture, but if you guys know, and I know most people know this, okay, even people who don't even listen to Korean music would know that K-pop fans in particular are extremely fatal. They're extremely toxic. They're extremely like diehard fans. And it's like, but y'all don't put this energy into anything creative in your community most of the time. And I'm not talking about everyone. I'm talking about some people. Don't apply, let it fly. But it is what it is. Like, that's just what I see. That's what I observe. And if you don't feel that way, it is what it is. If you're not like that, it is what it is. Like, listen, One Nation has been seen calling black girls gorillas. They've been seen calling black girls mannish and seen calling black girls everything under the sun but the child of God. And it's disgusting. And anytime someone has accused them or said something to them about any of these situations, they are just like, oh,
well, we didn't know. In the Korean culture, we don't talk like that. In the Korean culture, we call everyone a gorilla. You know, I didn't mean anything by it.
You're in America all the time, which means you ain't know. Like, you knew damn well. You just don't care. Anytime a black girl says something to you that you don't like, anytime she does not comply, anytime she acts like she doesn't want to do something or she's not interested, she's a gorilla. She's a man. She's ugly. She's unattractive. She's not a real fan. She's not a real supporter. All, like, regardless if you didn't know that gorilla or any other words were derogatory to black people, you should know not to degrade a young girl's self-esteem, a child's self-esteem. It doesn't matter what you called her, you're making her feel bad about herself, all because she doesn't want to do what you want her to do. If that's not a superiority complex, I do not know what is. These men are using their platform, their fandom, their money, their whatever it is that they got, because I have absolutely no idea how the hell they got it because their music is so goddamn trash, to lure in black women and use them for their personal gains and personal pleasure. Now, a lot of you guys are probably like, okay, but how did these girls even fall into this? How did this, like, even happen? Like, why? And I'm going to tell you this right now, and you guys are probably not even going to like the answer, but oh well. Black people love to fucking fall for the bait for everything. Black people gravitate to any and everyone who says something positive about them. And I'm not blaming these girls whatsoever, because children follow adults. And we as adults have the same fucking problem. One Nation sat there and was like, oh, we love black women. You know, up talk how much they appreciate black women, how much they love black women. So of course, that's why a lot of their fandom is black women. But realistically speaking, a lot of K-pop fans are black women as well. Korean music fans are black. That's the thing. There's a lot of them that are black. Not saying that there's not other races, but in this situation, we're talking about black people. This really, really hyped up their black fan base, in particular with the black girls. So when that happened, that is when the group started to form. They were added to the groups and so on and so forth. Black people, we need to just stop. We need to stop worshiping the ground that people walk on. We need to stop defending people just because they're our friends. We need to stop, like, just acting like shit isn't happening because it doesn't happen to us. We need to stop caping for people who don't deserve any type of fucking recognition or any type of bailout. Like, it's just ridiculous. We literally bait into everything. I'm not with people using us for their personal gain. And at this point, it's getting really, really fucking redundant and ridiculous. And I would just hope that black people as a whole, we do our research on things and not just follow the masses, not just follow a tweet that has 20,000 retweets, not just follow a viral video of a white woman saying something or a black woman saying something just because it got a lot of likes, comments, and views. This is not what we should be doing, and this is the problem with our community. We bait everything. We love everything that loves us, but they don't even love us. They just want our dollars. They want our attention. And in this case, they want our culture and they want the permission to do so. There's a reason why these people act, talk, dress, make music like black people. It ain't a coincidence, because we are one of a kind, and they steal it and they use it and they abuse it and they use it for their own personal, mostly negative gains. And it's absolutely disgusting that they think that they can use our shit and then abuse our black girls at the same time. No, not today, Satan, not today. Another issue I have is, I'm gonna say this again, y'all gonna be mad. I'm tired of these house slaves coming out now, okay? Now, in these times, calling out racism, colorism, and everything else of racial inequality. Now, the thing is, I'm referring to these people as house slaves because it don't make sense to me how now that people are protesting for racial inequality, now that people are pushing for change in the climate and, you know, overall diversity, that is when Jeffree Star is being outed again, Tana Mojo is being outed again, Shane Dawson is being outed again, Korean groups are being outed, companies are being outed, all this types of shit. And these are all from people that have been around forever. Like, these aren't people that just, oh, you know, I met Jeffree Star yesterday and he called me a black nigger bitch and I hate him. No. These are people that are coming out that have been friends with these people for years or for an extended amount of time. And these situations either happened a long time ago or are currently ongoing. But now that everything is going on and now that these situations can benefit them, the house monkeys then came out to play in the motherfucking field and they want to tell all the rest of us slaves. Okay, they want to tell the rest of us slaves what's going on.
This is what he did to me. This is what she did to me. They're not good people. They hate us. They hate us.
Where were you? Where? Really? Just really? Like, we're really just gonna sit here and act like a lot of these people weren't just being house slaves to their faves? It's disgusting. A lot of these people coming out were literally either brand partners, close friends, and this, that, and the third. Like, every single day I go on my newsfeed, there's someone new being outed for something. There's a new celebrity, a new company, a new this, that, and the third being outed for being discriminatory towards black people. This ain't new. Let's be real. Let's use our wins. This ain't new. This is not something that just started happening. All of these black people have been complacent. It's 2020, I don't wanna hear shit. It's fucking 2020. This is not a new fucking thing. This is not a new movement. You've been working at these jobs with these racist ass managers. You've been friends with these racist ass Korean group members. You've been chilling and doing photo shoots with these stupid ass racist ass beauty gurus. You have the nerve, the audacity, the gall to come and sit up in here and talk about something. Well, I'm sorry for not saying anything sooner. Bitch, you should be sorry. All of you people who are now coming out when it's convenient should be sorry. There are people coming out from a genuine place. Okay, I don't want anyone to watch this and think that I'm just saying, okay, well, they just should have shut up. No, my thing is, y'all should have said something sooner. And I know there's gonna be people that are like, okay, but never, better late than never. But let's be real, if the climate wasn't the way it was right now, would we really have all of this to talk about? Would we be talking about a lot of these companies, these influencers, these celebrities, and their disgusting, horrific comments and treatment towards people of color? Would we be sitting here calling for, you know, the end to colorism if it wasn't for these current situations? Let's be real. And most importantly, do you think that all of this is going to be in vain? Or do you think that history is going to repeat itself? I think history is going to repeat itself because it always does. And we're going to be fighting for equality for probably the next 200, 500 years. And this is nothing new. People do not know how to keep the same energy. Especially us black people, we do not know how to keep the same energy with much of anything. Is there some change happening? Absolutely. Do these people deserve to be called out? Absolutely. But I'm gonna need everyone who calls everyone out to actually do it when it needs to be done, not when it is convenient, not when the climate has changed, and especially not for their own personal gain. I also need everyone who sees things like this to take out the motherfucking trash. Don't just sit there and send it to me and send it to other people and expect us to talk about it when you can talk about it too. When you ain't never post nothing about it, you ain't even talk about it. You have to be able to talk about it as well. You can't just come to me and be like, oh, well, girl, let me tell you what's going on right now. Make a video, but then I go on your shit, you got two posts and it has nothing to do with what the fuck you're sending me. Like, it's ridiculous. You guys can do your part too. You do not have to have a huge platform in order to speak out about injustice, inequality, and especially sexual assault. Like, this is disgusting. And I genuinely don't think that this is okay. I'm definitely gonna hold all the adults accountable in the situation, from the friends, to the people in the chat, to the people that they contacted to try to tell their stories to, because at the end of the day, y'all should have did something, you guys. More importantly, okay, most importantly, should have reported this to authorities. These are children. This is revenge porn. This is child pornography. Why in the hell are none of you, did none of you reach out to the authorities? Because I don't get it. And I know there's going to be people that are like, oh, but why don't you do it? Well, first of all, I don't want to be in possession of nobody's nudes. I really don't. I know a lot of you guys were sending me receipts in my DMs. I was like, I'm not even gonna, anything that said sensitive image, I don't want to see that. And I don't want to be in possession of it. For the simple fact that I could get hit with a child pornography situation too. I am, in fact, going to look up some authorities I could contact for this information because it's sad. It really is. And they're constantly in and out of the US and they should not be able to step foot on our soil again. And just to let you guys know, this is not just black girls. There's also white girls and also other, you know, nationalities and ethnicities of women that they have abused as well. So honestly, I really even understand what their problem is. Maybe they're just misogynistic and they just don't care for women and they only care about women as sexual property. That's probably what it is. But a majority of this abuse has been done towards black girls. I find it blatantly disgusting that anyone was even supporting this group, not only because of what they're doing and the rumors that have been going on for quite some time now, but because their music is absolutely garbage. Like I said before, like, it's just really, really trash. They appropriate black culture so damn much. And like I said before, I wish we would put more energy into our black artists, especially the artists that aren't mainstream, who make amazing music, who try to educate us. And you know, it's just, it's disappointing to see that people would rather support garbage. If I'm gonna listen to garbage ass trap and rap, I would much rather hear it from my people because it comes from my people. I don't wanna hear it from them. Another thing is, I know there's gonna be Korean music fans that come on here and they're like, oh, well, this is why I only support this person. This is why I only like, no, bitch. You think these are the only people doing it? Let's be real. You think this is the only Korean music group out here disrespecting black girls? There's going to be more. And they're gonna start coming out of the woodworks because now they have the courage. One good thing about people trying to piggyback off of situations, because you know, it gives people the courage to speak out and say what they wanted to say, which they wouldn't be able to say or wouldn't have the courage to say if the situation was reversed. So that's great, okay? There's going to be more situations like this. And I'm not saying all Koreans are like this. I'm not saying everyone is like this. You know, y'all already know the shits. I'm really not. I'm just saying that we need to be more mindful of who we support and who we put on a pedestal, and we need to stop worshiping people. And we need to stop defending people when we do not know their whole entire character or true intent. With that being said, that is the end of this video. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, shop BGL Jewelry. Let me know what you think about all of this down in the comment section below. Have you heard of them? Do you support them? Do you not support them? Why or why not? If you have a personal story, leave it down below. And I'ma see y'all next time.